According to Bible, when you read Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6, it is impossible to please God without faith. Without faith, you cannot please God. So if you want to please God, in order to please Almighty God, we all need to have what?
Faith.
When we have faith, we are pleasing God Almighty. What will connect you with God Almighty? There is something on this earth which God has given to mankind that will connect us with the God Almighty. If you want to connect with God, what do you need to have? Not money. Money doesn't connect you with God. Your gold doesn't connect you with God. Your diamond necklace will not connect you with God. Or anything on this earth will not connect you with God. But the faith which is in your spirit can help you to connect with Almighty God. So many people are there in the world, and everybody are trying to connect with God. They fail to connect. Why? Because they are not using their faith. Bible says the believer should not walk by sight, but by faith. When God called Abraham, he obeyed God by faith. He started following God by faith. So everything was with faith. The faith works. Read it, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1 to 6. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. You are not able to see in many things, but you have to believe that will come to you. God will bring it into your life. See, Abraham was without children. He was lived a barren life. Till 100 years he was waiting for one child. God called him and said, I'm going to give you a child. He said, yes, Lord, I believe you. Then how many years he waited? 25 years. Near about 25 years, God's promise was not fulfilled in his life. Will you wait for one prayer request to get that request to be answered for 25 years? I don't think so. Only people, 1 year, 2 year, they will wait and they'll say, God is not answering my prayer. It's better stop prayer. They'll stop praying. But Abraham never stopped prayer. His faith was continued. He said, my God will never forsake me. In other words, he will never say lie. According to Hebrews chapter 6 verse 18 says, God will never say a lie. If he says a word, he will 100% he will fulfill it. Whether that may be a tomorrow or today or maybe after 1 year, after 5 years. If he gave a word, he will fulfill it. That's what the Bible says. So keep on believing on the word of God. So what will connect us with God is nothing but the faith. The people without faith, they will fail to know God. That's why many people will say, show me God, I will worship. Come on, show me God, I will obey him. You cannot see God. If you want to see, you have to see through faith. Faith has eyes. Faith can see, faith can hope. And whatever you hope for, you can see in one day, in a spiritual realm. So every one of us, we need to develop our faith life. To increase your faith, Romans chapter 10, 17 says, listen to words of Christ. The more you hear about Jesus Christ, the more you hear about the Gospels and the Word of God, keep on reading, keep on listening to God's Word, your faith will rise, So what will raise your faith? What will help you to increase your faith? Nothing but the Word of God. So when your faith levels increased, God's power will come down. The faith has a different levels. First one, no faith. Next, little faith. Next, great faith. Normally, everybody has a little faith in their life. But God kind of faith is something marvelous, something wonderful that can bring Almighty God's presence into your life. Jesus went to a village. People in that village, none of them said he's a Messiah. None of them they said that he's a prophet. Mary's son came. They never looked at Jesus as a savior, as a healer, any other. But just looked at him, he's also a human being. Our relative has come. In that village, none of them had a faith. So Jesus couldn't do any miracle in that village. In every village, he did performed wonderful miracles, manifested wonderful things, and demons came out, people got healed, water turned into wine, and sick people raised up and healed, dead man raised. But in his own village, none of them got healed because they all of them looked at Jesus as a human being. None of them believed he is a savior. He came to save us. He is a healer. He came to heal us. He is our master. He came to teach us. But they looked at him. He is also one of us. And said, he is a Mary's son. Matthew chapter 13 verse 53. So the people failed to receive miracles. Why Jesus did not perform any miracles there? Because of no faith. People in that village did not receive any miracle. Why? Because of no faith. If you don't have faith, God is not going to work in your life. Matthew 13:58. And he did not many mighty works there because of their unbelief. He didn't do any mighty works. Mighty healings did not take place in that village. Why? Because of their unbelief. So Jesus will come to your house. If you have full of unbelief, no miracle will work in your house. Nothing will happen. Next, little faith. When you look into the Bible, Jesus, our Lord Jesus said, you are of little faith. So when Peter had little faith, he sank into the sea. Why he sank into the sea? Because of little faith. So when you have little faith, you will sink into your problems. You will sink into your situation. You will sink into whatever that is coming to you. You will not overcome. Instead of overcoming, you will sink into it. But the little faith will not help you to come out of your problems, to overcome your problems. Next, great faith. There was one woman suffered from 12 years and she was almost near to death. She wanted to commit suicide or she wanted to end up her life. She was so much struggle. Every day there was a pain. Every minute there is a hell in her life. She went to many doctors. She used all types of medicines. The situation became more worse. And then she realized, for me there is no healing on this yet. There is no medicine on this yet. So let me end up my life. By the time one woman came to her and said, why don't you try Jesus? You tried medicines, you tried doctors, you tried everywhere. Why don't you try Jesus? He's the savior. He's moving in the villages. He's moving in the towns and cities. People are receiving healing. The moment she heard, through faith, she believed in her heart and said to herself, let me go and touch the garment of Jesus and I will be healed. She got up. She increased her faith and went to touch the garment of Jesus. Jesus was walking. Suddenly, she stretched forth her hand and touched his cloth. Immediately, the power went out from Jesus and entered into her body. She got completely healed within a second. 12 years pain disappeared within a second. Mark chapter 5, verse 25 to 34. She was suffered with the issue of blood. With the issue of blood for 12 years. Went to many doctors, went to many hospitals. But her situation became more worse. One woman said, why don't you try Jesus? By listening to her, she moved to touch the garment of Jesus. She increased her faith and she went and touched the garment of Jesus. Jesus said, who touched me? The Peter said, Lord, why are you asking like this? Everybody around you, so much big crowd, everybody are touching you. You said only one person touched you. How can I recognize the person who touched you? Then Jesus said that somebody touched me. I can feel the power went out of my body and healed that person. Who is that person? Who touched me? She came in front of Jesus and said, Jesus, I am the person. I suffered 12 years, Lord. I suffered a lot. I went to many doctors. I used all kinds of medicines. Nothing helped me. My situation became more worse than the first. Now, one woman told me that, try Jesus. Then I came to you, Lord. And I touched your garment. Immediately, the power of God came into her body and healed. Then what did Jesus say? My daughter, your faith has healed thee. That statement is great. Mark chapter 5, 34. And he said unto her, daughter, thy faith had made thee whole. Who healed you? I didn't heal you, but your faith brought healing. Your faith brought healing. That is your faith. So, many people tried Jesus. They couldn't receive anything from Jesus. Why? Because of unbelief. Matthew chapter 15 verse 28. Come on, read. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. What did Jesus say? O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. So how you desire, be it unto you. Receive it. Let it happen. What you are asking for, receive it. Now here we need to understand, Jesus is speaking about faith. Then he said about the miracles, he said about the healings. So the faith will connect us to receive God's power. So in your house, everybody, we all have electricity. Suddenly, light off, fan off, everything got off. Then what we will do, we just get out of the house and see the next house, whether they have power or not. So their light is still there. And this side house, they have light and fan. Then something wrong with what? Fuse connector. There's a fuse carrier. You will go there and you will take out the fuse carrier and look into that. Small, tiny, like a hair small wire is there, it got disconnected. So because of that, your fan stopped, your light stopped, your mixer stopped, your refrigerator stopped, everything in home stopped. Everything in home stopped. Everything in house, everything got stopped. Why? Because of the tiny thing got cancelled. The tiny thing got cut. What you need to do? Again, restore it. Take a small wire and then connect it. It is very tiny, but still it has power to bring a power from the tower to your house. Once you connect it, lights on, fan on, everything got on. When it is on, come on, tell me. When it on? When the wire got connected. How big it is? How big it is? Very small. But it brought everything switched on. That's what the Bible says. A faith looks very small, but it will bring God's power into your house. So many people are thinking, in their house, God is doing wonderful miracles. In others' house, wonders are happening. What happened to my house? No wonders, no miracles, no healing. What's wrong? So something wrong with your fuse carrier. Check up your fuse carrier. If you're disconnected in faith line, come on, connect it through the word of God. Connect your faith again. Once the faith is connected with God, power of God will flow like a river. The presence of God will flow like a river. So every one of us, we need to listen to God's word and start praying to God. So there are different levels of faith. The first level of faith is zero level of faith. So that means you are standing down ground level. That faith doesn't do any miracles. Just to believe God, that will be enough. Just to believe there is a God. Everybody says there is a God. That means there are believers. They are not atheists. They are not liberalists or some other people. They are just believing God. So next level of faith, when you get into the next step, that is the next level of faith. That is a little faith. Apostle Peter had this little faith. But little faith did not help him to walk on the water. He sink into the sea. When he was sinking down, Jesus said, "Where is your faith? You are of little faith. That's why you are sinking." The believers, they believe Jesus, they're following Jesus, but because of their little faith, they're sinking into their problems. Even though you're walking with Jesus, you're praying to God, you're worshiping God, but still you fail to overcome the situations in your life. Why are you sinking in your problems? Because of the little faith. So Peter had little faith. It doesn't work. It doesn't help you to overcome your greater problems. Maybe your problem looking like a sea, ocean. How to overcome? You can also walk on the water. When Peter, as long as Peter had faith, he walked on the water. When he had little faith, immediately shifted to the next gear. That is a little faith. When he had a full faith, he walked on the sea. When he shifted the next gear, he sank into the sea. My dear brothers and sisters, when wonders, miracles are happening, suddenly don't change the gear. Just go to the next gear. That is the next level. How many gears will be there in a vehicle? 4 or 5. Some vehicles 6. Okay. First gear. Some people always, they go throughout the journey only first gear. Engine will be making more sound. See, my new engine is wonderful sound. It is coming. Like a train engine, it is giving sound. It is shouting a lot because you are in. Come on, say. The believers, those who are shouting more sound, that means they are in first gear. They always make a lot of noise. Empty vessel makes much noise. So those who are always in the first gear in their faith life, they'll make a lot of noise. The second gear, sound little less, speed little more. When you shift to third gear, sound less, speed more. When you shift to fourth gear, more less sound, more speed. When you shift to fifth gear, you cannot hear the sound. Smoothly vehicle is going, no noise. The gear is in fifth. At the sixth gear, you can only see vehicle is moving. Air sound sometimes you can hear, but nothing. Everything is going smoother. Like that, every day in your faith life, shift to the next higher level. Don't go to the next level. Peter had a higher level. He walked on a sea. Suddenly he shifted into back gear, that's a reverse gear. That's why he started sinking. So my dear brothers and sisters, always go to the next level. The little faith and then the great faith. Great faith.
Great miracles.
Less faith.
Less miracles.
No faith at all.
No miracles at all.
That is the secret. So you need to understand why God is not doing miracles. He is always there to do miracles. But your faith problem. You have to set right your faith life with God. Abraham walked with faith. Enoch walked with faith. Noah walked with faith. People, they believed God. And they started walking with God. They did not see an idol, but they heard the voice of God. They started walking. My dear brothers and sisters, faith pleases God. Hebrews chapter 11, 6. So how many would like to increase your faith levels? If you take a decision to go to the next level of faith, lift up your hand. This is my prayer. Everyone should increase your faith so that you will connect with God, and the great faith will bring miracles and wonders. And not only your faith will increase, everyone in your house, around you, anywhere you go, by looking at you, their faith also will be stirred up. The faith should be stirred up others. Let's pray. Father God, increase my faith. Everyone say that. Lord my God, let me increase my faith. Let me listen to God's word. As your word says, Romans 10, 17, by hearing about Jesus Christ, our faith will increase. Father, let me increase my faith, Lord. Lord my God, I want more faith. Father, Master, teach me how to increase my faith. Lord, let me never live in a little faith. Let me always walk into great faith, Lord my God. Let me not stand where I am in a zero level of faith, but let me get into the little faith and more faith, Lord my God. As the centurion had a great faith, let me have a great faith, Lord. As that woman, Canaanite woman, she had a great faith and received a miracle from you. Lord, increase my faith, Lord my God. Master, give me a great faith. Let me walk in faith. Let me worship you through faith, Lord my God. As your word says, Lord, it is impossible to please God without faith. Lord, let me please you through faith, Lord my God. By walking in faith, worshiping God through faith, let me not walk by sight, but walk by faith. Teach me to honor you. Teach me to worship you everywhere, wherever I go. Lord my God, let me lift up your name. Let me exalt your name. I adore you, Lord my God. We adore you, Jesus. Father, touch your people right now. Increase their faith so that let them receive miracles in Jesus' name. The woman who came to Jesus with the issue of 12 years, issue of blood, but Lord, she touched your cloak and immediately your power went out of you and healed her. The same way, Lord, whoever is praying with faith, let the power of Jesus enter into their body and heal them in Jesus' name. Let the healing virtue of Jesus enter into every one of their body. Let them receive instant healing in Jesus' mighty name. Instant healings, Lord. We want to see instant miracles happening to them. Father, touch them. Increase our faith. Lord, teach everyone to increase our faith, to hear about Jesus, to listen to God's word, to meditate God's word, to pray and walk in a great faith, so that we may please you. We may walk wherever we go, walking by faith. The life will please you, Lord. Father, let me not walk by sight. Let me walk by faith. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.